Hey everybody, welcome back to the Mac Whisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. And if you're one of those people that's regularly late to appointments, or misses appointments altogether, or God forbid, double books your schedule on a regular basis, then this lesson is just for you. Whether you like it or not, calendars are a way of life. But after this lesson, you're going to understand the full potential and capability of your iPhone's native calendar. And with that, you're going to master your schedule, master your time, and be more productive than you ever thought possible. To start off, let's jump over to the phone and let's open up the calendar app. You'll see it right over here. There are multiple views of the calendar app, and we're going to go through them one at a time. First off, I'm going to click this back arrow in the upper left corner to get to the month view, and then all the way to the year view. The year view is the biggest scale view we've got. It allows you to see the entire year at a glance, but doesn't show you your appointments or anything within there. But the value of the year view for your calendar is it enables you to move through the entire year, or even prior years or future years, just by swiping up or down. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to leave the year view and we're going to enter into the month view. I'm going to do that by clicking on the month I want to go to, which in this case is September 2022. You'll notice that that's the current month because it's the one that's in red. I'm going to go ahead and click on it. When you open up the month view, you'll be able to scroll up or down by month to see what happened in August, or what you're planning for October. You'll also notice these little dots that show up on the separate dates to let you know whether there's an event or an appointment on that day. But from this view, you can't really see the details of those events or appointments. It's really more to get a glance and get an understanding. But if you notice up at the top of the screen, there's this little icon here, and clicking this icon opens you into the detail screen for the month. When you're on the detail screen, any day that you click on will show you all of the appointments on that day, and you can scroll through those appointments, click around to other days, and get a really good idea of what's happening on that particular day. So when you're looking at the calendar from a month view, having the detail screen on can give you all sorts of additional information that prevents you from having to move around to the week view and the day view and the year view by just staying in this one view. But it's also a little bit of a limited view. So I'm going to turn off the detailed screen here. This puts us back on the standard month view, which again allows us to scroll forward or backwards in order to find the day that we want to go into. Now, when I click on a specific day, I'm going to leave the month view and enter into the day view. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and click on today. The day view is the view that I use most often. But there's a few little tricks and tips that we're going to talk about while we're in the day view. The first thing I like about the day view is it shows me my whole day in an easy, simple way that allows me to know where I've got open space or what I'm supposed to do. But the day view has a different view that is called the list view. Let's step into that just for a moment so you can see what that looks like. You'll see it up at the top of your screen. It's those three lines right in the center there. I'm going to click on that. The list view allows you to see all of your past appointments, current appointments, and future appointments in one long list, which can allow you to very quickly get a good grasp of what's going on this week, this month, today. But my problem with the list view is it makes it hard to know where you've got available room, right? Because everything just kind of runs into everything, and it just looks like I'm busy every day, all the time. And that's not exactly true. So I'm going to turn off the list view again, bringing me back to the standard day view. At the top of the screen, you're going to see the days of the week. Underneath that, you're going to see any all-day events that are occurring on the day you're looking at. You can easily swipe from the left or the right side of your screen to go back a day like this, or forward a day like this. But there's an extra trick. Up at the top where we see all the days of this week, you can click on any one of those days to jump a few days ahead. For example, I'm going to jump straight to Friday the 30th, like that. And it makes it super simple for me to just hop around to specific days. But there's even another trick within that. If you swipe on those days at the top, it will jump you by exactly 1 week forward or backwards. So right now we're looking at Friday the 30th, and I'm thinking to myself, what's the date the following Friday? If I swipe up there, boom. Or I can go the other direction and I can say, what was the week before? As you scroll around through the calendar, sometimes you need to get back to today. It's always really easy to get back to today by clicking the Today button in the lower left corner like this. Now, let's talk about the week view for the calendar. The week view allows you to see the entire week at a glance, but it's not a button that you click. To enter into the week view, hold your phone sideways, and now I can see the whole week rather than just one day at a time. When you're in the week view like this, you've got your all-day events at the top, and you've got the separate days at the top. You can easily scroll left or right to jump yourself forward any length of time. One of the things that I've watched people do in a less than optimal way on their calendar is entering in a new appointment. The best way to enter an appointment on your calendar is not by using the plus button. The best way is to go to the day. You're going to press and hold at the right time. So I'm going to press and hold at 1 o'clock. It puts a new event right there. Now when I let go, I can give it a title. We'll say this is dinner with Frank. And I can click add, and I'm done. I'm gonna go ahead and turn myself into week mode by spinning my phone this way. Let's go to the 25th, and I'm gonna put this new appointment at 4 o'clock, hold it down just like that, and this is my friends for lunch. The other thing that you can do easily is changing an appointment. I'm gonna press and hold on that event and I'm just gonna drag it to where it needs to be and that's done. Now, what if this appointment that's currently scheduled for an hour is really a 3-hour dinner? No problem. What I can do is activate the appointment again by pressing and holding on it. And then at the bottom, you'll notice this little ball. I can click that ball and drag it as long as I need it to be. I can also grab the ball from the top side of the event to make it start earlier. You can even drag it to the right or to the left to put it on a different day without ever having to type anything in or go into that details screen. Now that we know how to easily create an appointment, let's talk about some of the things that we can do within the appointment itself. I'm going to go ahead and start by clicking on my dinner with Frank tonight. The first thing I need to do is click on the edit button in the upper right corner. That opens up all of the capabilities that I can do for this specific appointment. I can give it a location. That means that if I have to drive there, the calendar can alert me in advance so that I'm not late. But maybe it's not an in-person event. You can also put the URL of your video link right into this section. That way, when it's time for that Zoom meeting, all you have to do is click on the appointment and click on the location, and it'll immediately jump you right onto that call. You can also come in here and adjust the day and time, but if you learned how to use your finger to move events around, you won't need this very often. Down below that, we've got the option to allow an event to be repeating. Let's say I want to have dinner with Frank every month on this day. It's very easy to do by just saying every month, or it could be every week. Or what if it's a little less specifically scheduled? I can click here and I can choose custom, which will give me the option of how often. Well, let's say it's monthly. Well, when on the month? Let's say it's on the first Thursday of every month. Or maybe it's a weekly thing. And I can say it's on Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Obviously, Frank and I are gonna get to know each other really well if we have dinner every week on Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday, but I'm just using this as an example. I'm gonna go ahead and get out of the edit event screen, and let's look at some of our other options. One of our options is to use multiple calendars. Even though it seems like to have multiple calendars means it might get really complicated, it's really just talking about different categories for your schedule. I have several different categories that I use in order to organize my calendar. Let's take a look at them. If I click on this button here, it's going to show all the different options. Maybe this is not a really personal dinner, but it's a little more professional, and I could put it in my business North Star Man calendar like that. Or maybe we've decided to not do it as dinner, but just do it over the phone, and I can change it to my calls calendar. You can have as many different calendars with as many different colors as the rainbow will allow. You can create whatever categories of calendar you want. We'll talk about that more in just a moment. In addition to that, we've got this option called Alert. Alert will let you get an alert on your phone, your computer, your iPad, even your watch if you want it, at a specific time. If you put a location into that event, you'll notice that down under Alert, it defaults to alerting you when it's time to leave. But you can always click on that and say you actually need to be alerted the day before, and you also want a second alert at the time to leave. It's very easy to use these alerts so you don't forget an appointment or somebody's birthday, and if you use the time to leave section, you'll never be late. The next thing we want to talk about is how to create a different calendar so that you can organize your events. Down at the bottom of your screen, you're going to notice a button that says calendars. Go ahead and click on that. So you can see for me, I've got a Gmail and I've got an iCloud, and that's about it. Down at the bottom, you'll see some subscriptions, which can include holidays, or maybe you're Jewish and you want all the Jewish holidays listed on your calendar. If you're looking for things like that, don't create it manually. Just find it online and download and subscribe to that calendar, and it'll show up right at the bottom in this other section. You'll notice that each of these separate calendars has a checkbox to the left. If it's checked, that calendar will show on your screen. If it's not checked, you won't see that calendar. So if it's not something I need, I might uncheck it so that it doesn't distract me when I'm in the calendar. Unchecking it does not delete it. It just removes it from the screen. You can always come back and check on it at a later time. To the right side of each of these categories, you're going to notice that little friendly lowercase I that always means get more information. I'm going to click on the tentative calendar on the I. And right here, I get the option to rename the calendar, share the calendar, or change the color. I can even tell the calendar I don't want to be notified with any events for this calendar. This is really helpful if you've shared your wife or your husband's calendar and you want to be able to see it, but you don't want to get beeped and notified every time they go to the dentist's appointment. Sharing a calendar is a great way to collaborate with people. Maybe you share it with a member of your team, or maybe you share it with a member of your family. Sharing is easy. Just click the Add Person button. You go right into your address book, type the person's name, click on their name, and when you click the Add button in the upper right corner, it will add them and invite them to this calendar. And if they accept it, they will be able to see this calendar and make changes to it, and you'll be able to see the calendar and make changes to it, and you can work together to create appointments that you both go to. Now I'm going to click the Done button in the upper right corner, which takes us back to our calendar list. And you'll also notice that down in the bottom left corner is a button that says Add Calendar. I can click that to create a new calendar or to add a subscription to a calendar that I've downloaded off the web. Clicking the Add Calendar button will ask me what I would like to call this calendar. Down at the bottom, you've got your color, and you can pick any color, including clicking the Custom button, which pulls up a whole color selection toolbox, including a grid of different colors or sliders that allow you to incrementally change a color to be exactly what you want it to be. I like to use the grid to really pick the different shades and pick a blue that's a nice light blue or a yellow that's a nice muted yellow and go from there. Once you've added the calendars you've needed and selected the calendars you want, you're ready to really start using your calendar. And the last thing I want to talk about has to do with when you create events. Most of us create events that are reoccurring. Maybe not on a regular schedule, but when I make an appointment with my dentist, he's at the same location that he was the last time I made an appointment with my dentist. So when you create an appointment, press and hold, let it go, and bring it in, pay attention to the autofill options. As I start to type, you'll notice that it brings up matching events from the past. And by using these matching events, I can autofill the name, which calendar I want it to be a part of, and even the location. Here we are, that's my dentist right there. I'm gonna click that button, and now all the steps are done and all I have to do is click add. So that's what we've got for today's lesson all about the calendar. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, take a moment, hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so you're always alerted whenever I drop a new video. With that being said, I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and it's my purpose and profession to help you get more done in less time and with less effort on your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And with that being said, I'll see you next time.